Good morning, everybody. Welcome back. Throwing Solomon has got selections here for Friday, May 24th. Four again today's play of the day. Quick recap what happened yesterday. We had a loss in WNBA with Vander Sloot under 6.5 assists and minus 125 on BetMGM. Pretty brutal beat. She had 5 assists with about 2.5 minutes to go in the game. And then she had 2 assists in the next minute and a half and then got pulled. So ended up with 7. Pretty brutal beat there. Kind of sums up how we've been running lately. I'll look for a winner here on Friday. Before into the actual play, though, do want to remind you once again that we have more picks on the Winners Winers website. So don't forget to check out the website to get picks for experts. Use promo code XCZAQ4R30 to get 30% off. Code is also in the description. Plus, get on from BetMGM. So if you're looking for a new book and BetMGM's book you're considering, you should join. Or do so, use the link, and it'll get a nice sign-up bonus. Plus, a reminder, hit the like button, subscribe to the bell so you get notified, and you'll never miss an episode. Now, for the actual play, going to baseball, going to look at a matchup between the Giants and the Mets taking place at around 7 p.m. Eastern time. And for this game to go with a team total, going to take the Giants team total over 3.5 runs at minus 105 on BetMGM. Time recording of 9:30 a.m. Eastern time. Covering why we're going to take the Giants team total over in this game. First reason, the Giants have quietly been fantastic offensively over the last 2 weeks. The Giants have scored at least 4 runs in each of their last 7 games. And on top of that, they've actually scored at least 4 runs in 10 of their last 11 games. So San Francisco offensively has quietly been very good and very consistent. And with that being the case, I do think 3.5 is too low for a team total when they're on the road getting a guaranteed 9 at-bats. And you're looking at the actual offense for the Giants this season. This offense has randomly been better on the road than at home this season, as the Giants are averaging 4.38 runs per road game, which is more than the average at home. So I do think they should look a bit sharp offensively, at least more than what the oddsmakers expect. And I think that 4 runs is actually a pretty modest goal for the current form of this offense. So I think they're going to end up reaching that in these 9 innings. On top of that, the Mets pitching has been consistently bad for the last 2 weeks, as the Mets have allowed at least 4 runs in 9 of their last 10 games. And they've also been bad at home, as the Mets have allowed at least 4 runs in 5 of their last 6 home games. But you're also looking at the pitcher for this matchup, relative unknown. They have Scott pitching for New York. And in the last 2 starts, he has not been good. 10 innings pitched, a 6.3 ERA. So you're looking at the Mets pitching staff once again being underwhelming, allowing 4-plus runs in 9 of 10. The Giants, though, have scored 4-plus runs in 7 straight, and they've scored 4-plus runs in 10 of 11. And you have, I'd say, a wild card on the mound, let's put it that way, for the Mets. Simply put, I think this team total is too low. I'm going to back the team that's gone over this number regularly for the last 2 weeks at a pretty cheap price of minus 105. Spoiler alert once again, here for Friday, May 24th, it's going to be on the Giants team total over 3.5 runs at minus 105 on BetMGM. Bye, everyone.